Today, I came out here because I wanted to give the Department of Workforce Development a better idea of what happened on the day I was suspended from work at the UPS store. You can kind of see it in the distance. There you go. So the UPS store is located there. I believe their property extends directly in front of their store. So their property, the property of the UPS store, is inside the store, and it goes, I'm on the public sidewalk right now, and it goes, the property of the UPS store goes out directly in front of the store. So the UPS store's property is right here. This is their property. My car is the black Chrysler there, and that is where I parked almost every day that I came to work over there. So as I arrived to the property from there, I took a right, I came down this avenue, and as I was driving down this road, the owner of the GM of Jimmy John's was at his car. Do you see where that silver car is? So he was parked right there. He was parked, the owner of the Jimmy John's was parked right there where my finger is, right behind my Chrysler. So right behind the Chrysler. So as I approached the owner of the Jimmy John's restaurant, he was standing like this, and then he started to bend over just like this. So where my knuckles are is how his butt started to come out of his pants. And he did that twice. He did that two times, each time as I was driving slowly down this road right here. So as I was driving slowly down this road, the owner of the Jimmy John's started to bend over slowly, and as he did, more of his butt came out of his pants. And I think the guys in the gay community think that's like a sexually attractive thing to do, or an irritating thing to do to somebody. And I think he did that purposefully as I was driving towards him to irritate me with sexual harassment. And the owner of the UPS store is lying, is trying to protect that behavior and denying that it has anything to do with starting an altercation. It has any instigating tendencies. Which is a lie. We're not idiots. We're adults here. We know that there are men who are gay who irritate other men with sexual harassment. And the owner of the UPS store is trying to ignore that. But anyways, his property extends straight out. And the place where I had a conversation with the guy, the Jimmy John's general manager, was right here where he parked his car. So his car was parked right there. So that's directly in front of Jimmy John's property. So usually the way these places set up their property lines is they go straight out in front of their stores. That is how all these businesses set up what their property lines are. So they have parking spaces that belong to them. I mean, people who go to this entire shopping mall can park anywhere in here, but if they had to put each property in perspective, they would tell you directly in front of their business is their properties. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 businesses on this block, on this block of property, and the UPS store's business property lines would exist over there. So considering that I wasn't on their property and the owner of the UPS store said that I was, I think that's called a lie. When this incident occurred, when I seen this man's exposed butt and I told him to pull his pants up, that occurred right here, right here. And I made this video so you could have a better perspective of when, where I was at the time I parked my car, or right before I pulled into the station. And as you can see, I am parked directly in front of Jimmy John's. This is where my car was parked at that time. Someone is telling me to add, in my left ear, telling me to add that the guy from Jimmy John's got back into his car and drove in front of the UPS store, right on the other side. He drove and he parked on the other side of that red van, right in front of the UPS store. And then he waited there for 40 minutes thinking that a manager was going to come outside and speak to him. It was around 9:35 when this man started waiting. 9:35, 9:40. He then drove his car. He left, came back. I think he drove all the way around. He probably drove around the parking lot. I'm sorry. He drove around the parking lot. He left. He went this way, or whichever way he went, came back around, circled, and then the second time he passed the UPS store, he stared into the store and gave me a very angry look, and then continued to drive by. But my point is, when I told the guy at Jimmy John's to pull his pants up, he was parked right there and I was parked right here. But I could see his butt cheeks from where he was parked all the way down there. So I have pretty good vision. This camera can't tell you what's written on that screen from this point of view, but I can tell you what it says. It says organic pink lady apples, 3 pounds a bag. If I zoom in, you can now see it says organic pink lady apples, and now it says local Wisconsin Meadows beef, gross fed rib roast. But from a distance, you can't tell what that's saying, but I can. And just like I can read that sign down there, I can see this man's butt cheeks coming out of his pants from all the way over here. And he is using cameras to diminish what could actually be seen. So the cameras can't tell what is actually visible to the human eye, but the human eye can see a lot better than a camera can. Like, you can't see what that says. It says anyone can shop, join to save, become an owner. So I'll zoom in. And now you can kind of say anyone can shop, join to save. But my point is, the owner of the UPS store is going to lie to you and say that the camera doesn't show that much nudity. But as I just proved to you, cameras don't see as well as a human eye can see. So the owner of the UPS store is playing stupid, and he knows his cameras can't visually see as well as a human eye can see. So as I drove up to this location, the man exposed much of his butt to me as he could, and then he and the owner of the UPS store diminished how much of his butt could be seen based on what a camera could view. But that's not reality. Reality is the human eye sees a lot better than a camera. And they're playing dumb, like they don't know that's true. Like, that's not common knowledge. So He lied to you about where this incident took place. It took place on Jimmy John's property. It took place at 9:32 in the morning. Both of the, he said it was on his property, and he said it was before. It took place on company time. I Googled what company time was, and it means company time means you have to be being you're being paid by the company, compensated for your time by the company you work for, and you have to be responsible and get rid of all personal like obligations at that moment. So at 9:32, I was not being compensated by the UPS store for my time, which indicates I am not on company time. Jack McWilliams stated on official DWD documents that I was being paid during the time that this incident occurred. That's a lie. He also stated that I was on his property when this occurred. That is another lie. He also stated I instigated this altercation. The instigation began when the man decided to expose his butt very slowly as I approached him. As I got closer to him, he decided to show me more and more of his butt. And he did that twice. So I wish I could show you, but I can't. If you can imagine a man slowly bending forward and raising his butt out of his pants, that's what I saw as I slowly drove towards him. So I tried to make sure it wasn't timed perfectly. So I tried to make sure that as I drove down this path, I didn't see his butt. But as I slowed down, he slowed down bending over. So he made it last a little longer. He took a long time to put his kid in the car. And as he did, his butt was coming out of his pants. And I think gay people think it's sexually attractive to slowly pull your butt out of your pants to give another man an erection or make another man sexually attracted to what you did. I think everybody knows that. And if anybody is denying it, they're playing dumb. They're playing dumb and they're trying to protect the gay community and their behaviors. But that's what happened when I got here. This is where it happened. And I posted a timeline of when I arrived to this location to prove it didn't happen while I was being paid by the company. Or I wasn't on the clock at the time. I clocked in at 9:44 or 9:45 in the morning, 15 minutes after I arrived to this parking lot. I sat in my car and I ate breakfast for 10 or 15 minutes. And then I walked from my car to the store of the UPS, to the front door of the UPS store. And when I did, I walked from this car right here to over here. So I walked from here. The man's car was parked right here. His car was parked right here. And then he took his car, and you see where that car is right there? He parked his car right in front of the UPS store. So right in front of that silver car is where the man parked for 40 minutes and waited outside the store. So as I was about to clock in to work, I walked towards the UPS store, and the man got out of his car when I approached the UPS store, the door. When I approached that door, the man got out of his car and started talking to my coworker. And then when he finished talking to my coworker, he looked at me and said, do you think that was appropriate the way you spoke to me? And it wasn't until that moment that I decided to speak back and explain to him that what you did was stalk me and sexually harass me to irritate me. But I didn't say that. I didn't say that at all. I just said, do you think it's appropriate to do what you just did to expose your butt solely to the public? And he replied, I don't know what he replied. I don't remember. I have to watch the video again. But he ignored what he did. And he tried to purposefully bring, get me in trouble. He thought getting me in trouble with the owner of the UPS store would benefit him, would get me fired. That's what he was after. So it wasn't about, this was not about anything I did while I worked at the UPS store. This was about this man retaliating because I didn't appreciate what he did. I didn't take it the way he wanted me to take it, to be attracted to somebody bending over after so many years of watching or seeing a naked man's butt in public. I was supposed to be attracted to it. But instead, I made it clear that I didn't like it, and I asked this man to pull his pants up, and he didn't listen. He didn't want to listen to me. So he figured, why not get this man fired? Or if you're not going to have sex with me or the people who work for the UPS store, the people who work at the UPS store are people in the gay community. The owner hired me and made me work with gay people. And that's the working conditions I was in. So the guy who works at Jimmy John's figured if I don't like naked men's butts, why not get this dude fired? Or no, I'm so sorry. What I just said is not true. He was upset because I hurt his feelings. I rejected his sexual offer. He bent over very slowly to expose his butt to me, and he was upset that I rejected his sexual offers, and he asked the owner of the UPS store, who supports the gay community, to fire me because his feelings were hurt. So they were helping each other out. And then the owner of the UPS store decided to lie to the Department of Workforce Development because he doesn't want to pay for someone who isn't gay to have unemployment benefits, to get unemployment benefits. So that's what those are the lies he told to escape responsibility for terminating somebody for something they did outside of company time, off of company property, and for an incident they didn't instigate. So the incident was instigated by the owner of the Jimmy John's. He was trying to have sex with me or make me sexually attracted to his butt. That was the incident. That was the instigating incident. This man was trying to get me to be attracted to seeing him slowly raise his butt out of his pants. And when I told him I didn't like it, he got mad and told my employer he made up a huge, escalated the situation. Well, lied. It was a lying escalation. So it wasn't actually escalated. He just exaggeration. To get me terminated from work. And then the owner bought those lies, well, accepted the lies, and told them again to you and to me to get me terminated from work. But it's all over unemployment benefits. It's really non-consequential. And that's probably why he's lying to you guys. He knows at the end of the day, these are inconsequential lies for him, but they do hurt my feelings. The lies nonetheless hurt my feelings. And have a bad mark on me. And I think he was hoping, the owner of the UPS store was hoping that I would become violent. I would decide to do something violent because of the lies he told. And nobody was there to stop the lies being told. So I think people get upset when they hear lies told about themselves. And I think he decided to tell lies to make me upset, to make me feel upset and hope that those upset feelings led me to violence. I'm just going to tell. I mean, no matter what he does, at the end of the night, I'm going to end up telling. So I don't want to have sex with anybody who's gay. And I also don't like being lied on. So I don't know if you guys are going to be, if you guys can understand what I'm trying to say, but that's exactly what happened. The owner lied. And he used the dude from Jimmy John's to help him terminate me because while I was working there, I refused to have sex with my coworkers. the gay community that I worked with, they were trying to get me to admit I was gay and have sex with them while I worked at their store. And since I refused to do either of those things, the owner had to get rid of me. I was causing this I was making them look bad by not having sex with them and not proving to the society or the community we live in I was willing to be gay. So that's what the owner of the UPS store did. He got really upset that I was not having sex with my coworkers. And I was making him look bad. See that? See that dude just tried to. He just tried to show me his butt, and now he's staring at me. He came out here because he knows if I get, I can't keep the footage of anybody's naked butt on my camera. So he thought he'd come out here and show me his butt, so that I'd have to delete this footage. My probation and parole won't let me. If somebody walks across the camera and I see their butt, I'm not allowed to keep the footage anymore. I had to delete it or give it to a police officer and then delete it. But I can't keep it and post it on the internet or post it on YouTube or give it to anybody. I have to delete the footage. So that guy just walked out here and tried to show me his butt. You can't see it, but from where I was standing, his pants were about to fall down, and I could see his red underwear beneath his pants. So I don't know if you want to play that back and look at that, but that's what just happened. But like I said, that was my working situation at the UPS store. There were people there who were gay, entirely gay. The whole crew that I worked with was in the gay community, and Jack supports the gay community. And as long as I was working there and I was not having sex with my coworkers or proving to the community I was gay, Jack looked like he was defeating the purpose. Jack looks like a liar, and the gay community looks like a liar. So they figured, just get rid of him, tell lies about his character, his work history, so that he looks like a bad person when the next person tries to hire him. But that's not who I am. I'm a pretty decent person. I'm pretty honest. I'm pretty straightforward. I like being in society. I love our community. I love the idea of being in society because there's so much to offer. So I know life is huge, and I'm trying to tell on these people who are trying their best to get me to have sex with gay people or not allow me to work anywhere in the community or be a part of our society. So that's what happened, and I'm going to give you this video, and if you need the video that shows me arriving and parking right here, I will give that to you as well. But I'm going to leave now, and that's basically what happened. That's what happened.